Vanakkam. Now, I am going to cover the practical approach of a bank audit. How to commence the audit and what are the things you have to take, what are the things you have to bear in mind before going to the audit and during the audit and after the audit, as well as the registers you have to see. This is a thing I want to discuss in this video presentation. Before going for the presentation, I request everyone to subscribe to my YouTube channel, Ravindran V. This step-by-step approach is needed, has to be followed for all types of bank audits. That is for statutory branch audit, for concurrent audit, for stock audit, for revenue audit. In general, everything you have to follow this procedure, and this will be useful even for everyone's personal life also. So now you have got the appointment letter because you have been selected by a particular bank to do the branches. So now you have got the appointment letter. Now you are about to go to the audit. And what are the things you have to follow? First thing, you have to send the acceptance letter to the concerned appointing authority. Whenever you receive any appointment letter, you have to send the acceptance letter to the concerned appointing authority, including declaration of fidelity and secrecy and all the certificates they want. Then you have to inform the previous auditor's permission, because you have to get the previous auditor's confirmation, that is permission, as per our ICA norms. Otherwise, we will be caught as per the professional ethics code. Then you have to get the address of contact numbers of central statutory auditors, because in case of any doubt, they, you can contact them. Then you have to take the desk officer contact number at the controlling office. After that, you have to get the branch manager's name, branch details, then their contact number. And don't forget that these contact numbers you have to inform to your family members. In case your mobile phone is out of reach, then they can contact this number. Then confirm the exact location of the branch, because sometimes place confusion will be there. In Tamil Nadu, Mangalore is one branch, Mangalore is a place, and Mangalore is a place. So then you have got a pronunciation difference, so you have to get the correct exact branch location. Then route map to reach the branch you have to put. How to start, where to start, how to reach, what's the route, how to reach the branch you have to prepare. Then transport mode, how we are going, whether by car, whether by bus, in which mode we are going, whether by train or by flight, which mode we are going, you have to prepare the transport mode. And also tour schedule, because you have been allotted two branches or three branches, which branch you have to start first. So you have to prepare two schedule with priority. Then if you travel by car, if you prefer to travel by car, send a mail to regional office or zonal office as mentioned in the sanction, as mentioned in the appointment letter, to take the permission. Otherwise, you will not be getting the reimbursement of expenditure. Then you have to work out your staff availability. How many staff are available, for whom we have to allot the work, everything you have to plan in advance. This is before going to the office. At your place, you have to decide. Then hand over all the branch details to your staff and tell them that you have to hand over these details to your, their family, because their family are, they are also need to contact the staff in case of urgency. Then you have to educate the staff, spend at least one day, you teach them how to arrive at the NPA, how to do cash verification, jewel verification, document verification, everything you have to educate them, staff, because otherwise you have to update them. Then prepare an audit program for you and for your staff. That is very much important. Then you have to attend seminars to update the knowledge. Even sometimes you have to take your staff to to also for the seminar. See you. See that you have to see YouTube videos relevant to bank audit. There are so many videos, including my video. My video is also there YouTube in YouTube. The YouTube name channel name is Ravindran. So if you see, then you will get the details to update your knowledge. And don't ask the branch to bring all details to your office. Few auditors in the past days, they used to ask the branch managers to bring the files to them. Now they refuse. So don't do it. Then educate the staff or tell the staff that the audit period is the financial year. That is, it starts from April to March. Only for that period you have to do the audit. Then you have to update the knowledge in NPA classification, as well as you have to educate your staff. This is a thing you have to be prepared before leaving to the branch for audit. Then now you are started to leave, you are planned to leave from your office. What are the things you have to take on file? First, take the appointment letter given to you by the concerned bank's head office. Only by showing that appointment letter, you will be allowed to do the audit, otherwise not. And also you take empty number of Xerox copy of the appointment letter, because sometimes you may miss it. You may misplace it. Sometimes your staff would have misplaced that. Then you have to take your ICI identity card. Then prepare audit commencement letter. Before going to the audit, before commencing the audit, you from your office, you prepare a commencement letter saying that today I plan to commence the audit with the following staff. Their specimen signature, their signature is being attested by me. Kindly give permission to commence the audit. That is the procedure. You have to give the letter to the branch manager. Then in case your staff is going in advance, that means without your presence, if he is going in advance, then give authorization letter to the staff. Then take all stationaries relevant to the bank audit from your office, such as white sheets. Don't go and ask the branch to give white sheet bundles. A4, give me two bundles or three bundles, because I need it for audit. Don't ask it. You have to take from your office, plus all the notebooks. In case they want to write a notebook, they have to take that. Then take calculator for each staff, including you. Four of you are going, then take four calculators or buy four calculators for the audit purpose. Then take tack, eraser, scale, pencil, stapler with pin, stamp pad, gum. Apart from that, you have to take file and bag to carry those items. Then in case if you are going for a rural branch, water will be a problem. So take water bottle with you, or buy water bottle if it is available. Don't drink the water at the branch, because due to water change, you'll be affected. And also you pack food items. Sometimes in rural branches, you will not be getting food. So you have to pack food items and have some snacks with you. Then you have to take the letter pad. Your letter pad, you have to take in sufficient quantity. So you can even you can take some three letter pad book. Then take seal, rubber stamp, contains full address, initial address with membership number. Then take cell phone with cell phone chargers, and if possible take power bank. Take towel, because in rural areas there will not be AC, so you will be getting sweating, so use towel. So take towel also. Take train reserve ticket, and mostly take cash, debit card, credit card, checkbook. These are the things you have to take, because when you are going outside, you will not be getting the enough cash. Then also take the medical kit, because four of you are going, then sometimes stomach upset will be there. Have some generic medicine. Suppose if you have got dysentery problem, you take anti or Suppose if they got stomachache, have cyclopam, if they got fever, have dolo 650, but everything depends on the doctor's advice. Plus, if you're a diabetic, take all sugar tablets, cholesterol, and BP tablet, everything you have to have it in your medical kit, and as well as spray, painkiller, because sometimes the scam will be there. So you have to take. Then boarding and lodging details you have to take. You have to get it, where to stay, and what all the lodging facility you have to see. And very, very most important thing, now all auditors have been asked to sign the P&L and balance sheet and other forms in digital mode. So you have to take the digital signature with you. Then now you have prepared everything. Now you have entered the branch. Then you have produced the appointment letter, you have produced the commencement letter, everything. The manager, he will definitely welcome you. And what he will ask, the following are the general questions that each and every manager in some other angle they will ask, but this is going to be a very big information for the youngsters who are doing the audit for the first time or second time, even for some seniors also. Sir, when are you going to complete the audit? This is the first question they will ask. Then he will say, sir, there is no space to sit. You have to adjust. Yes. Then, sir, how many persons came for audit? Because I have to provide the seats. Then, sir, last year auditor, he came here and did the audit for 2 days only. So this is the information I want to ask, I want to tell, because they indirectly say that you have to complete the audit within 2 days. This is the thing they will tell. Then, sir, what about your character? Are you alcoholic or non-veg or veg, he will ask. Then what about your food habits? So at what time you need food, everything you will inquire. Then, sir, do you want to go to any place for sightseeing? Because these are the things, if sightseeing means, if they mention means, that means they are wasting your time. Don't deal to it. You can go at any other thing. Then say that, and he will say definitely, sir, there is no hotel nearby in this place. We have to travel some 10 kilometers away from this bank. That means if you agree to it, that's why I already said you have to pack food items. If you agree to it, then from the branch, you have to travel 10 kilometers. For that 30-35 minutes go, he will provide food for 1 hour, then you have to come back for another hour, so 2 hours gone. Then after eating heavily, you have to take this, so another 15 minutes or 20 minutes gone. So almost 2.5 hours gone. So don't go out of the branch, because your time should not be wasted, because you have to complete the audit in time. And normally they will say, this is the last bus time, sir. You should you have to leave, plan the audit work accordingly. And he will ask, sir, which area you want to commence the audit first? Whether it is cash or advance or jewel verification, he will ask. Then, sir, forms are not ready. Still, the head office has to send the form. So you have to bear with us. You have to wait for the forms. Then only I will be in a position to give the details. If that is the case, you start to verify the advance documents. If forms are not ready, you have reached the branch, don't bother. If they said forms are not ready, do cash verification, do jewel verification, and advance document verification. You ask for the advance document, you do it, and even you can arrive at the NPA schedule on your own. So don't wait till the forms are being provided by the branch. The manager used to say that, sir, I want to go on leave because I've got LTC, I have to spend time with my family because my son has come from US, I have to spend time with him. So I want to go on leave, kindly do the audit. He will pressurize you to complete the audit. Then he will ask about the entertainment, what are the entertainments you want. Then the regional office pressure, he said, sir, regional office has given me the pressure, so kindly do the audit at the earliest. If you are doing the audit in pressurized mode, you will miss lot of things. So have a audit program and do the audit. And they say that, sir, there is no staff at the branch level. We are doing the work. I am doing the work. Only officer is there. No one is helping us. So they will give their grievances. And sometimes they dictate that, sir, don't do this first. You do this. So they dictate the preference of audit. Don't yield. Then another thing they will say that, sir, Our software is very good. Computer is maintaining the accounts. Interest calculation is computer takes care. And even the NPA calculation. So don't bother about NPA. Everything is correct. So that's the thing they will tell you. Then you have to do it. You have to do the NPA. Then, sir, you have prepared everything. He will prepare all the forms, everything, including your tax audit report, including your LFIR. Tax audit report and LFIR, they are all your domain. Don't allow the branch to prepare it. You have to verify and prepare it. Then forms, you ask them to prepare, and it's only a printed form. You can take any number of copies because you are not going to sign anything. Then you can, after verification, you say that everything is correct or not. Then, sir, I have got a promotion, sir, don't put NPA. If you put NPA, then I'll lose my promotion. Don't put in that manner also, they will give pressure. Then another thing, they normally all, not all, but almost 70-80% managers, they used to say, we can say few managers. So, sir, last year auditor has not put any MOC. You don't put MOC. Even this year also, all other auditors in our region, they have not put MOC. So, don't put MOC. So, in that manner also, they have said. Then he said, okay, give the findings, sir, I will change. Then in some four cases, I have experienced this. Sir, I have identified some account as NPA and manager is not able to convince me. Then he said, sir, customer wants to meet you. If you said like that, then you have to report this to the head office because you are not supposed to meet the customers in person because you are supposed to discuss everything only with the branch head, not with the customer. Don't involve directly with the customer. Otherwise, you'll be in trouble. And he said, sir, there is no terminal available. Whatever, we will spare only one terminal with our staff. We will not give you a separate terminal. Okay, even if that is the case, you sit with that officer, you do it. Then he said, sir, in branch, we have got union problem, sir. So staff relationship is not that much of good. So I'm not able to even manage the branch. In that manner also, he will tell. Don't you do any such thing. You do the audit as per your audit program. And before proceeding, you have to ask the manager the thing as, sir, when you join the branch, what is your duration? Everything you have to ask. Suppose if he said, I just 2 months back only, I joined the branch, then you ask about the previous manager where he was transferred. Then you have to get the appraiser details. Who is the appraiser? What is his agreement? Everything you have to ask. Then if there is any field officer, you ask the manager whether this field officer is for two branches or three branches, because there may be chance that that field officer may operate the account from the other branch. He may log your branch, this branch account at the other branch. There also there will be chance for misutilization. And you have to ask about the staff strength. Who is the officer? How many officers are there? How many clerks are there? Everything you have to ask. And I want, at this juncture, I want to say only one thing. Who is the professional informer for your audit? First, you have friendship with manager and everything, but you have to be close with the sub-staff of the branch because he knows everything. Be close to the sub-staff, but close only to the bank audit purpose and not for some other purpose. Then you will get all information about the branch. Then you have to see what about the quarter, staff quarter, and see the agreement. You ask the manager to produce staff quarter agreement and rent agreement for the branch, and is ask the manager to produce, is there any complaint register? Ask for the complaint register. Then ask for the TDS details, and the TDS register you have to ask. Then balance sheet file, you ask for the balance sheet file. That is with reference to P&L account and balance sheet and attached to forms. What are the forms you have to to do the audit, and also certificate forms to be obtained from the manager, because you are going to certify the forms. You ask the branch to fill the certificate form. then you verify everything, then you ask the manager to sign first, but don't sign the certificate and any report first as auditor. But everything the manager and officer, he has to certify and hand over to you. Don't certify on yourself first. Then tax audit report, long form audit report format, and you have to get a specific letter from the manager stating that so far no fraud has taken place at this branch. Thus, you have to get a separate letter from the branch head. Give a letter in writing to branch manager. If you want any other details, you have to give it everything in the writing and get the details. And what about the audit format? Audit certificate format will be there. You have to ask for the audit format, and that you have to see the main thing, whether that branch has earned profit or loss, because normally they say profit slash loss. Normally, you should not sign blindly. Either you have to strike profit or you have to strike loss. That you have to observe from the P&L form. Then you have to ask for the MOC forms. Memorandum of Changes form will be there. Then NPA statement for this year and the last year you have to. Then do the audit as per audit program and get the checklist before thing. What are the things you have to verify? You have to get a checklist and get it verified that if the manager has produced all forms. And I already said one thing, you have to compare previous year NPA statement with this current year NPA statement. Then only you have to, whether all changes have been done properly, this you have to take care. And this is the first part of my presentation, step by step of bank audit approach. And please watch the other parts, because that is going to be the base for your audit. And you have to take either a note and pen and write down all the details, because I'm presenting in video mode, so I'm not able to give the written mode. So you take a pen, pad or notebook, take in writing so that all registers, all behaviors will be taken care of. With this, once again request you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'm going to present the other video. Thank you very much for watching this video. Nandri, Vanakkam.